In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place. And everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and the line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available to them. We now invite you to sing "O Little Town of Bethlehem" with us, and the first two lines are missing, but we're sure you all know it, so hit it on the third line.
Nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born for you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those to whom his favors rest." Now we'll sing "While Shepherds Watch Their Flock by Night."
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us. So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child laying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what they had been told, what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told to them. Please join us in singing the first Noel.
After Jesus was born in Judea during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all of Jerusalem with him. We now invite you to sing "In the Bleak Midwinter" with us.
Until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, And they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. We will now have our men's choir singing We Three Kings, and we invite you to join in the refrain that is printed in your program.
Amen. of joy, renew us in the joy of your salvation, and make us a living sacrifice to you, for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Heavenly Father, this third week of Advent, let us remember that the good news of Jesus' birth has the power to bring us great joy this Christmas season. Our joy isn't dependent on what is going on in our life, in our world, or the people that we are with. It doesn't depend on the gifts we give or the gifts we find under the tree. Those who gathered around the new baby were blessed because they believed that you had fulfilled your promises. Mary and Joseph believed that they were able to feel the joy of holding baby Jesus in their arms. The shepherds and wise men believed that the angels and the signs and experienced the great gladness of worshiping their Messiah. Those who knew him and recognized him were overjoyed at the coming of Jesus. They trusted in your promises and their hearts were filled with gladness as they watched your loving kindness manifested in the face of a tiny baby in a lowly manger. Father, you gave us a reason to celebrate when you gave us the unspeakable gift of Jesus Christ that first Christmas. Our joy doesn't come from our jobs, our family, our relationships, our finances, or our success. Our joy doesn't come from what we have on earth or who we are with. Our joy is a gift. Our joy is encompassed in our Savior, Jesus Christ. Flood our hearts with this joy this Advent season as we reflect on the good news of Jesus' birth. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Before we depart this evening, this afternoon, we would like to acknowledge the generous items given in memory of family members. The Christmas tree given by Kevin and Susan Vino and family in memory of Urban Vino. The Advent wreath given by Wilfred Jodry and family in memory of Erna and Scott Jodry. After the closing hymn, we ask you to remain seated to receive treat bags from Bruce and Heather Vino and family in memory of their parents, Lester and Pauline Vino, Donnie and Eva Rainey, brothers Eugene Vino, Alan and Bill Rainey, and Ford Rover. We'll now close with the hymn, Let There Be Peace.
Thank you.
Be the people of joy. Let joy live in your heart and share the joy of Christmas with all you meet. Share joy by seeing the good in each other. Share joy by remembering good times and hoping for good times to come. Share joy by praying for your world. In this Advent season, we need to see, feel, and share joy. As you go out into the wonder of God's creations, share joy, peace, and hope with those you meet. Amen. Amen.